please welcome to the stage Jamie Williams, Principal Adversary Emulation Engineer.
I know that guy. That's awesome. too kind. Welcome. And, you know, for many of you, welcome back. It's been a really long time since we did this, and, you know, Power Hour was great, but nothing really replaces this atmosphere, coming together as community. You know, we've been here for a little over an hour, and it's already amazing just catching up with folks and meeting new people and really, like, cherishing this attack community. So I actually had one job now, and I'm not going to goof it, and my one job was to not talk too much. So with that, I'm going to introduce our actual master
for a safer world. Through our private public-private partnerships and federally funded research and development centers, we work across government and with industry to tackle some of the world's biggest problems. So we were here 2.5 years ago, and this was the last slide of AttackCon 2.0. Little did we know. It's been a long time since then, obviously, trying to keep things together. As Jamie just mentioned, we did do a virtual conference at the end of 2020, AttackCon Power Hour, trying to keep the community, bring things together. So, you know, we've continued to keep our outreach going through, you know, all the different channels that we've been able to find, whether it's our external Slack that now has over 2,000 people in it, getting out to people on Twitter, which we added something extra over the COVID break, getting 10,000 of you in for AttackCon Power Hour. So we have more than 5,000 of you registered virtually today. Obviously, there's about 125 of you in the room, so thinned out due to COVID, but you're trying to get information out to as many of you as possible. You're also a really international bunch. So on Friday, I was looking at attack.mitre.org website stats, and I discovered that we had visits in the past month from every continent and every country that Google tracked, except for North Korea, okay, and Iceland. So we don't know what we did to Iceland, but whatever it was, we're sorry. So while we've been trying to keep our communication paths open, get information out, we really rely upon the community for everything that it is you do. And so the bulk of the presentations, books, training, everything else that's out there around attack is created by you. And so thank you. And, you know, we're looking to keep that coming. So a little bit of information on the conference. And it's going to be slightly tough because the confidence monitor isn't working. But so for submissions, we had our first submission come in just 18 hours after the CFP opened. So, you know, one of you was really rearing to go. And a fairly traditional conference stat, our last submission was 69 seconds before the CFP closed. And the bulk of our submissions, more than half of them, actually came in the last 2 days. So this is also an international group. It's also a group of procrastinators. We saw 16 countries represented in our CFP. Now, this is lower than usual because, you know, we're asking speakers to travel. Thank you. And, you know, so it's, you know, a smaller number, but it's still a lot of you coming from a lot of places to potentially talk about attack. So our acceptance stats. So I don't know how many of you know how we actually handle AttackCon. We run it like a traditional conference, though. We have a 6-person program committee who is starting out by reviewing all of the submissions blind. That is, the program committee doesn't know what company or what person submitted them. So the first score that's coming in is just based on the content. We get together, we unbind the reviews, and we choose the speakers that you'll be seeing over the next 2 days as a program committee. We're also a pretty selective conference. So this year we had a 24% acceptance rate. So the talks you're gonna be seeing over the next 2 days are, you know, drawn down from that space. Now you're gonna unfortunately or fortunately see a lot of me the next 2 days, but there is a lot of people standing behind me on the attack team. We have over 40 MITRE staff members who are supporting attack in some way as well as the growing external community. I wanted to recognize a few of them, get them to wave if they're in the room, and talk a little bit about the areas that we break attack up into. First off is Attack for Enterprise. This is the framework that most of you probably know if you know attack. It's Windows, Mac, Linux, cloud, et cetera. And that's run by my co-MC, Jamie Williams. Yeah. So we've broken off a few spaces within Attack for Enterprise that we want to put particular focus on. We think have some unique aspects to them. We want to give particular attention. So the first of those is Mac and Linux. I think she's out there on the, Kat Self, who you'll be seeing in just a little bit. live tweeting from the front row, we have our attack for cloud lead, Justin Roberts. Is kind of a separate matrix that we released last year is Attack for Industrial Control Systems. This is its own space. It talks about different types of devices. And so our Attack for ICS lead is Otis Alexander. Not here with us today, but another separate matrix focused on iOS and Android devices is our Attack for Mobile framework. And that's led by Jason Ashmo. Attack has always been made up of describing adversarial behavior from the point of view of an adversary combined with a defensive information on how to work with it. And so we recently reorganized the defensive parts of attacks, that is detections, mitigations, data sources, and CAR, a cyber analytics repository, into a separate defensive group. And this is led by Lex Krupton. Attack has a ton of open source software that we put out. We have infrastructure that we run, everything from Attack Navigator to our website. And that works all led by Jared Ondrachek, who's sitting in the back. All that groups and software information that you see in Attack, so everything focused on threat reporting on particular actors, is led by Matt Malone, our threat intelligence lead. And last but not least, the editor-in-chief of our blog is Amy Robertson, who runs outreach along with myself. And that's just 9 of us that are leading the different parts of this 40-plus person team. So we couldn't do this event today without our event sponsors. This costs a decent amount to do. You guys all want to eat. So we wanted to thank our event sponsors who were for both our virtual and full event. Our virtual event sponsors are Analyst One, Cyborg Security, Microsoft, and Pentera. We get a round of applause for our virtual event sponsors. And then we have our full event sponsors. And so these are the organizations that actually have tables downstairs. We absolutely encourage you to visit them, say hi, thank them. And those are Attack IQ, Cyber Ranges, Kroll, Picus, Trellix, and Trend Micro. We get a round of applause for our full event sponsors. So if you're watching online, and we will be piping it into the room some over the course of the day, we're going to have some exclusive online content coming from our AttackCon couch. So we bring up Kat Self. So Kat is around the corner, going to be interviewing our speakers after they've given our talk. that's probably enough torturing of Kat. So if you're in virtually or if you're in person, we're going to be having a lot of our conversation today on attacks open Slack. So if you aren't a member of our Slack yet, this link on the left will get you into it, or the QR code that's right above it is the same link, I promise. If you're already in our Slack, this channel, this link on the right, will take you straight into the channel. And again, take a shot of the QR code. For each of the talks, especially if you're coming in from the virtual audience, our questions and answers are going to be coming in from Slack channels called AttackCon3-QA- the last name of the speakers. Now, we have somebody who's going to be in the main AttackCon channel. They'll be letting you know sort of when to go to each channel. And Jamie Williams will be using questions from the Slack as well as questions in the audience when we do Q&A. Another great way to engage with us is Twitter. So we're out there a decent amount. We tweet, we like memes, and you know, we'll be potentially reading some of the best that you guys send out from online. And we'll be live tweeting for the next couple days the conference. So we have, as our live tweet team for the next few days, we have Mike Hartley, John Wunder, and Justin Roberts. And so, you know, if you want us to actually be seeing something, we really do like memes. Get those GIFs out there. And similar to how I pronounce GIFs, I will agree that it is pronounced Mishta.